How does a practical joke become an icon almost overnight, especially on a game like Arsenal? Well, a quick answer would be is that the community's insatiable pursuit for bragging rights led it to go on a wild goose chase, idolizing something that would become a symbol of its own audacity and foolishness. In today's video, I will be covering the history of the monkey skin and the events leading up to its creation and what they would cause. If you went around 3 years ago, those days were the golden age of the Arsenal community. Before the false promises of Reloaded, before the Great Bed Wars purge, and when the development team still featured people who actually cared about the game's health. It was also when the YouTube scene was still very popular, which was what really propelled the entire community forward through the pandemic. In this period of time is when our story begins. Specifically on May 14th, 2020. This is when Tanker released the 24th edition to his 0 to 100 series, entitled Perfect Map and Mode. If you don't know who Tanker is, he was one of the most influential content creators until he quit to play Bed Wars. When he released this video, the development team back then, and still today, doesn't, let's just say, enjoy most of the content creators' presence in the community.
Why did the devs not like Tanker? So, I never got to know him personally, but he definitely caused a lot of problems in our community, and that's kind of like the general reason why we were not very like on par with him. He would do things that would like cause mass upset, and I can't say whether or not it was intentional or not, because he never bothered addressing it or even apologizing for things that his community did.
This is the only clip that I'm aware of the developers talking about how they disliked Tanker and the things he did. Crystal wasn't a part of the Monkey Skin saga, but just keep this fact in mind for later. Specifically, 7 minutes and 31 seconds into the video, Tanker would find himself in a Sandtown randomizer match, which was his favorite map and mode combination, hence the title. While absolutely destroying the lobby, he arrogantly said the phrase, "Anyone can do it," which I can only assume gave the quote-unquote villain of the story a good laugh and an idea. Castlers is a developer who's been a part of Rolf since its creation, and if you don't know what he's known for,
ladies and gentlemen, we got him.
Remember how I said Rolf never really liked content creators? Well, Castlers wasn't an exception. Him, along with his friend and fellow developer Scaptors, decided to create a wild goose chase, which of course would be the monkey skin. Except before we continue, I have to point out some of the facts about why the skin was originally created are a bit unknown. My theory is that Castlers and Scaptors had planned to create the monkey skin long before Tanker made his video, so then when they would release it, they would bring a bunch of attention to Arsenal before the summer update, leading to more players and thus more money. But then when Tanker made this boastful remark, they thought it would be funny to make him the laughingstock of the event by making the description of the badge, "Anyone can do it." Yes, this is genuinely the connection between Tanker and the creation of the monkey skin. If you don't believe me, Tanker talked about this in his "I did the steps for the monkey skin" video a few days after the event's release.
On one of my episodes on level 0 to 100, before the guy who made the event started saying it, I actually said it in one of my videos. I will play the clip right now. See, anyone can do it, man. It's not difficult.
Anyone can do it.
Now with the monkey skin's origins out of the way, let's start talking about its release. The earliest known mention of the skin's existence that I could find was on May 21st, 2020, in the Arsenal Discord server. Castlers wanted a general posting screenshots of the skin, presumably shortly after adding it into the game. If you go on the Arsenal Wiki update log, it lists the monkey skin as being added on the 22nd, but clearly this does not seem to be the case. For a few days, there's very little mentions of the skin anywhere on the Discord server and on YouTube. In fact, there are only 8 across the entire server on the 24th. On the 25th of May, however, interest in this new mysterious secret skin would start brewing. In a John Roblox speedrun video posted that morning, Castlers would say something rather interesting in the outro.
So, do you want to say something for the viewers?
There's a new monkey skin. If you saw it from John whenever I was wearing it, you gotta figure out how to get it.
It was at this point the community had its confirmation. The monkey skin was real, there's a way to obtain it, and the chase for the first person to complete the quest was on. Following the release of this video, a high-level Arsenal Discord server user by the name of Aphix, if I'm pronouncing that right, would post a clip in general a few hours after the video was released. This was later reposted a couple times, hence why there's so many messages mentioning the skin starting then. Over the next few days, there was no new information released to the public, but interest in it was still relatively high, as you can see by the graph. The more mainstream parts of the community wouldn't catch wind of this new event until the 5th of June, which is when you can see things really start to amp up in mentions. In the morning, casters would send some quote-unquote hints into the announcement channel, but of course the main reason why things picked up the way they did is the monkey skin was making its first appearance onto YouTube. Firstly, Bandites uploaded a video the night before, showing his DMs with casters asking about the event. For lots of people who just woke up in European time zones, this was their first time hearing about it. As well, Bandites DMs with casters revealed what the timeline would be for the monkey skin event. Specifically when it would end. You would have up until the 20th to get the skin, which is when the Summer 2 update would release. It's also now pretty apparent that this whole thing was to hype up the community for the Summer update, and that sure worked. John made a video in the morning attracting more attention, and still both of them had somewhat loose information to share. Later in the day, Bandites made 2 videos talking about it, one which showed more of his conversation with Castlers, and another where he talked about more information regarding the steps. Because of Bandites' inquiries, by the end of the 5th, it was publicly known that you would need to be on Beach, wear the Red Panda skin, have the mode be standard, be in a public server, have the potassium power weapon equipped, knife the palm trees in a certain order, win, and say the phrase, "I bet you can't guess it, anyone can do it," in chat. This brought up 2 main problems though. The chances of getting the potassium power AK were now raised to be almost impossible. Any attempts you watch of people trying to complete the event all have one thing in common. It took them hours to get the AK to even be able to have a chance at doing the rest of the event. The second thing was, if you weren't a content creator, good luck getting people in public servers not to instantly kill you the second you try and climb up a tree. Remember, this was before movement changed, so you couldn't just shoot up the trees in 2.3 plank time like you can now. Only the most diehard event hunters, which were few and far between back then, would have any chance at getting the monkey skin. The sheer promise of greatness is what I believe really made it so tantalizing for the common player. Even though the odds were insurmountably stacked against them, it was theoretically possible, or so they thought. Once the steps were made public, people realized that begging in general wasn't going to get them anywhere, which is why there's such a large drop-off in messages in the Arsenal Discord server all the way until the 20th. Don't get me wrong though, there was still plenty of misinformation going around. In one case, there was a guy who apparently figured it out, but I'm pretty sure it was just Scaptors on an alt where he gave himself it. Speaking of Scaptors though, he was probably the biggest solicitor of giving people false hopes in general, as he did a bit of misleading by referencing the ongoing cowskin event multiple times and also pretending like somehow random objects on Sandtown were correlated. Out of any day of the event, June 7th seems to be the most important, which I'll now be talking about in this little section. It started off in the morning with Chase Rooney making a video, and he was very popular at the time, which obviously brought more attention to the monkey skin. But more importantly, it was the day that John and Tanker streamed themselves trying to complete the event. It started off with John's stream where he tried to get the skin for a couple of hours, and then eventually Scaptors showed up and started trolling him. I don't have any images or videos of this, by the way, because the stream was privated and he didn't show anything in the video he made afterwards. Then after a while, Scaptors just gave him the skin and John really didn't know anything. Neither did he figure out any new information. Tanker's stream, however, was entirely different as he tried to do the steps 100% legitimately. After 8 hours of trying to get the requirements to complete the event, he finally had his one shot at getting the monkey skin. Like I talked about before, with the 2 main problems you would face, he was able to overcome these with his audience and also just like the amount of time he put into it.
All right, let's see if this is the game, boys.
Oh!
Now that Tanker had the correct map, skin, gun, and mode, he typed in the two phrases, anyone can do it, and super secret Poggy Woggy. The second one came from one of the dev's scripts, but it ended up turning out to be just simply incorrect. He then pulls up this map of what order you're supposed to hit the trees in. I'm not gonna lie, in my research, I really couldn't find where this originated from, but I can only assume it was like the Arsenal Discord server or a data miner posted about it.
Let me up! Let me up! There's too many people, dude.
You can definitely see here how hard it was to climb up the trees, but luckily it did manage to climb this one and as well all of the other ones in what was the correct order. After Tanker finished climbing up all the trees and knifing the things at the top, all he had to apparently do was just win the game. After that, he should have been able to complete the event and get the skin, right? Well, it looks like the answer to that question is no, he did not get anything by doing the steps. So what went wrong? At this point, Tanker had proved that what everyone had thought about the event to be true was false. With no new information being released by the devs following the events of the 7th, people started speculating this was in fact a strategy developed to garner more attention and money for the release of the Summer 2 update. But is this what was really going on, or was the community just missing a step? After the stream, Tanker made a video talking about what could have possibly gone wrong, and he believed it was something to do with the code or phrase that you would have to enter in at the start of the match. On June 9th, he made another video talking about a new step that was released, which is that you have to use 120 FOV. To my knowledge, this was more or less confirmed by the devs, so Tanker decided to stream himself doing a couple more attempts. Once again, all the streams relating were privated, except at the end of Tanker's Steps and Clues video, where he showed him doing it again with 120 FOV from a stream. The footage is sped up, but it appears that Tanker did in fact complete the event with all the confirmed steps, but it still didn't work. This is also interesting because after the event was over, Castlers made a video talking about the way that you would have actually gotten the monkey skin. I tried asking around in the Arsenal Wiki Discord server and just with my friends if anyone had it, but I got no responses, so I can just assume for now it's pretty much lost, except of this one screenshot I took of it when it was still public. In the video, Castlers goes on to explain the steps of how you would have actually gotten the skin, except these were identical to the things that Tanker did in his final attempt on stream. Which leads me to the conclusion that it seems that the entire event was actually impossible the entire time, and the only people who got the skin were either gifted it because they were a YouTuber, or because they were trusted within the community. Like I said, Tanker used the exact same steps that Castlers talked about on the 9th of June, which would have given the community a whole 11 more days to try to complete the event. That would explain why no one got the skin legitimately well after the steps were known and confirmed to the public. In conclusion, the monkey skin has been cemented into Arsenal history as the most iconic visual the community has ever come up with, and it will remain that way until the game's eventual demise.